Twitter's popularity continues to rise and rise. And with the year we've just had, with so much happening in the world, that has definitely been the case. So in this video, I'm going to give you my rap on Twitter, the good, the bad, and the ugly, and that's all coming up right now. So straight into it, we are on this video on my Twitter profile, Mark Warnken. And if we aren't yet connected or if you're not following each other on Twitter, by all means, follow me on Twitter. Send me a direct message as well. Let me know where you're tuning in from around the world. So this video is all about Twitter, the good, the bad, and the ugly. That's right. Twitter is all of that. And it is many things to many different people as well. And I'm going to explore, as the title of the video says, the good, the bad, and the ugly of Twitter. Now, I will say at the outset, I believe Twitter is fantastic as a great resource for many, many reasons. So I'm probably going to be focusing more on the good. I will have some information on the bad, of course, and of course the ugly, but most of it is overridingly good as far as I'm concerned. So the number one reason that I feel Twitter is a great resource for information and everything else that it's there for is you can really stay up to date with breaking news. And quite often the breaking news from around the world from your own particular city breaks first on Twitter. It's really easy to tweet. It's really easy to get your message out and about. Think of it as a bit like texting the world, how easy it is for us to text people. So probably the first reason that I like Twitter so much, it's really easy for us to stay up to date with breaking news in real time. Now, that also means you can then spread information about your business and brand by, you know, tweeting out and promoting yourself, your business and brand as well. So it works both ways. You can receive information, you know, breaking news in real time. Equally, it allows you to, you know, do the same by, you know, posting to your Twitter news feed really quickly, really easily, done from your mobile, done from your tablet device. You can use the desktop, which is what I'm showing people here. It's just scrolling through my news feed. Most people are going to be viewing Twitter though on their mobile, but there's a few early reasons. And here we go, another update. CNN. This is the Pfizer vaccine for COVID, things like that. So basketball news there in my news feed, the Sydney Morning Herald, that was an ad. Donald Trump, of course, we all know him. Major League Baseball, all of this information quickly and easily at our fingertips. Just this morning, a couple of tweets that I put out. One of them was here, my next YouTube video, I'm looking to highlight some great looking LinkedIn profiles. So I've shared on Twitter, I'm looking for examples of great looking LinkedIn profiles to promote and highlight in my next video. Nominate below. So I was able to use Twitter to reach out to my network, to reach out to the wider community online and on Twitter around the world, saying, hey, if you've got a great LinkedIn profile and you want to feature in my video, I would love to hear from you. I love being able to promote myself, my business and brand, share relatively information, and you get real-time engagement in feedback as well. Another great reason, you know, Twitter is good for so many reasons is you can get, you know, feedback and engagement in real time. So if you're umming and ahhing about, you know, a certain product or service, or you're just, you know, confused a little bit about, you know, a color or a design or whatever, you know, you go to Twitter, go to social media, ask people, would love your thoughts. Do you like A? Do you like B? Do you like C? So there's a couple more reasons why Twitter, I believe, is good. Now, of course, any times we are, you know, posting on Twitter, we're producing a tweet, you're always wanting to be adding an image. You know, an image will stop the scroll. Videos are very popular as well. So adding video links, best practice again, is you all want to be adding your hashtags. Twitter, amongst many things, is also a giant search engine and a database. And that's how people, you know, search on Twitter. We search on Twitter by, you know, the hashtag symbol. So best practices, when you're tweeting, you might be able to mention someone in a tweet as well. Highlight the tweet to someone, maybe even send them a direct message as well. So how does all that come into play? Let me just copy and paste some of that and I'll show you how easy it is to tweet. We would have some content here. I then might want to nominate someone. Let me nominate my friend Edward, who's a business colleague here in Australia, or not nominate, tag them, sorry, mention them. So I've highlighted Edward's name. We would then add our hashtags, you know, LinkedIn, you know, LinkedIn profiles, that type of things, P-R-O-F-I-L-E profiles, or if I could spell properly. And I've got the space, and you would add an image as well. So that's how simple and quickly it is to tweet. I'm looking for examples. This is replicating the one I've just done before this morning, so I won't do that. But best practices, add a video, add an image, maybe mention someone in it, add your hashtags, and that's how simple it is. And that's one of the reasons why I like Twitter so much, and I'm increasingly liking it, you know, over the other social media platforms as well, is it's really easy to share your story, to share your information about yourself, your business and brand. And another reason why Twitter is fantastic, or is the good part about Twitter, is that it's a giant database and a search engine, as I said. So, you know, if you were to put someone's name into Twitter, it's really easy to connect, you know, with someone on the opposite side of the world, you know, in some cases quicker than it is going outside and saying, you know, hello to your neighbor. So let's just put a search for like Dan Andrews. It's going to bring up all the people, I suppose, who are on Twitter anywhere around the world. Dan Andrews, he's a member of parliament. He's a politician here in Australia. But equally, it's going to be, you know, curating the news feed there, or not the news feed, the search of all the Dan Andrews or Daniel Andrews. That's how simple and easy it is to connect with people from the, you know, anywhere in the world, as long as they have a Twitter profile. And you can start following them. You can start direct messaging them. You can start engaging them. You can start, you know, mentioning and tagging them in one of your posts. And another reason I like Twitter so much is you can curate your own newsfeed by following people and companies and brands on Twitter, and you can then stay up to date when, you know, they're tweeting, when they're posting on Twitter. So, you know, you're very much able to customize the newsfeed that's going to come through. Now, I'm seeing, you know, information on the NFL, SportsCenter. These are generally companies that or brands that I'm already following, but that's why my news feed, you know, is curated with information about those particular products. So that's another great reason. You can follow and engage and stay up to date with businesses and brands and celebrities and sports stars and individuals, you know, very much tailored to your, you know, your current interests. That's the time. And finishing up on all of that, I suppose the number one reason that Twitter is so good and so popular, as is all of the social media platforms, is it's free. That's right. Everything I've just shown you is free to do, free to use, free to consume. Twitter is free. There's about half a dozen reasons why Twitter, from my perspective, is the good. So we've moved on to the good. Let's now move on to some of the bad things about Twitter. So what are some of the bad things about Twitter? Now, firstly, bad is a subjective term, I suppose. For each individual, we get to determine what is good and bad. But from my point of view, one of the bad things about Twitter was also one of the good things, is that it's actually free. That's right. It's free that we can use Twitter in so many amazing ways. Equally, the fact that it's free allows anyone to get online and then start spreading their information or misinformation and causing mischief and doing whatever they want to do. So as we scroll through the news feed, we're suddenly confronted with, you know, whatever the world is got to offer for us via the Twitter news feed. So in some ways, the fact that Twitter is free is also one of the bad features of it, because, you know, anyone and everyone can be involved with it. That leads to fake news, misinformation. You know, who knows whether, you know, you could say the same about any of the social media platforms. I saw it on Facebook, I saw it on YouTube, I saw it on LinkedIn, I saw it on Twitter. But, you know, very much so, fake news. You need to take information on Twitter with a grain of salt. You know, misinformation and the like. But the good still far outweigh the bad. Another thing that I suppose, you know, is bad for us, we tend to scroll, you know, way too quick, and where our attention span has now been reduced by consuming social media, that, you know, sometimes we're missing out on great content because we're scrolling too, you know, quick. We're looking for the next shiny object, just like I'm doing now, scrolling through my newsfeed, seeing what catches my eye, that type of thing. So in some ways, there's so much information, we can't actually consume it all. And sometimes that information comes from fake profiles. That's right. Anonymity on Twitter is in some ways, you know, some people might say is good, but for a lot of people, if they're up to mischief, they can quite quickly and easily and create a fake Twitter profile and then start spreading that, you know, hate speech and misinformation relatively easy. And another bad feature, I suppose, of Twitter and all of the social media platforms, as we scroll through sitting on the lounge at nighttime, it can become addictive. That's right. We can easily start spending, you know, vast amounts of our time, you know, instead of engaging in the wonderful world we do live in with family and friends and talking to our family and spouse and children, you know, we can get consumed and absorbed with all the available information. As I'm just scrolling through here, there's probably stuff that is caught your eye. That's, you know, that's the nature of Twitter. That's the nature of the news cycle. The information is so easily available. But, you know, in some ways, that's, I believe, is a bad thing as well, that we're, you know, our depth of knowledge, our depth of, you know, engaging with someone has been vastly reduced. Which now brings us to some of the ugly sides of Twitter. And I said at the start of this video, but from my perspective, you know, I think Twitter is fantastic, you know, a great opportunity for all of us to use it in whatever way, shape or form. Now, unfortunately, that means, you know, people use it for, you know, not good means and not good reasons. And, you know, the comments on Twitter sometimes can be, you know, appalling. You know, there was a politician once who said, and I can't remember who it was, but it went along the lines of, you know, Twitter is fantastic, just don't read the comments. And I think that sums up a lot. You know, my early times on social media, you know, I would take quite offense to, you know, some of the people who would say comments about my YouTube videos or, you know, things that I was posting on Twitter or LinkedIn. So the comments can be very, one of the very ugly sides of Twitter, you know, hate speech, you know, vile hate speech and things like that. And, you know, that's all wrapped up, you know, in what we now commonly know as trolls. So as we're scrolling through the home feed, you know, people can sign up and be on Twitter and they can be anonymous. They're scrolling through on their lounge at nighttime in a dark room and, you know, retweeting misinformation, you know, terrible comments, you know, trolling people, direct messaging them and everything else that goes along with that. So there we go. There was my take on Twitter, the good, the bad and the ugly. As I said at the start, that's all from my perspective. What I'd like to do, I'd love to hear from you, your take on Twitter. Tell me some of the good things that you like about Twitter. Equally, I'd love to hear from you on some of the reasons why Twitter is not for you. Go to the comment section below and let me know if you're watching this on my YouTube channel. Equally, by all means, send me a direct message. Follow me on Twitter. Shout out and say hello. If you're watching it on my LinkedIn profile, Facebook page as well, leave a comment and let me know your thoughts. Mark Warnken, Social Media Selling 123, signing off from another video, and I look forward to seeing you again real soon.